I think there must be something wrong with me, Linus. Christmas is coming, but I'm not happy. I don't feel the way I'm supposed to feel. I just don't understand Christmas, I guess. I like getting presents and sending Christmas cards and decorating trees and all that, but I'm still not happy. I always end up feeling depressed.
Charlie Brown, you're the only person I know who can take a wonderful season like Christmas and turn it into a problem.
Maybe Lucy's right. Of all the Charlie Browns in the world, you're the Charlie Browniest.
Hey everyone, welcome to the final episode of Christmas in July. In this episode, we're going to be talking about what is probably the most classic of all of the things that I've reviewed this month. We're going to be talking about A Charlie Brown Christmas. Now, I'm not sure if I've ever actually seen this. I remember a lot of it, but it was not one of those things that was like a childhood staple, like we have to sit down and watch this every Christmas, like I know it is for a lot of people. However, as a kid, I was a huge fan of the Peanuts comic strip. I had books. I always read it in the newspaper. But the only movie of Charlie Brown that I ever remember watching was Bon Voyage Charlie Brown, because the library had it, and we borrowed it once. Other than that, I don't really remember watching any Charlie Brown animated specials. I'm familiar with a bunch of parts of this, because different bits and pieces have been memed here and there, and I'm sure I've seen clips on the internet. So parts of it are familiar, and I remember parts of it as being comic strips that I read when I was a kid. So I was familiar with the story as a whole, but I don't know that I've ever actually seen this. So I was finally introducing myself to this thing that should have been something that I watched years ago, but I don't think it was. I have to say, I really did like this, but it wasn't exactly what I was expecting. I don't really know what I was expecting. It wasn't something that seemed like something that would be made today. Like, it's far slower paced than pretty much anything made for kids these days. And I liked that about it. It made it, I don't know, I felt very relaxed while I was watching it. I don't know that I felt like I was having a great day, but I don't know, this just made me feel better about life, which I think a lot of Charlie Brown things do. I kind of identify with Charlie Brown maybe a little bit too much. He seemed very depressed, and I don't know whether that's a good thing that I was identifying with that aspect of his character or not, but I liked the overall message about it, about Christmas being too commercialized. I really liked that they had, like, the true meaning of Christmas in there, but they didn't do it in a preachy way. It was just part of the story, and that was it. The way they handled it was just really well done.
And the angel said unto them, "Fear not. For behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord."
As far as the main story goes, there's not really a whole lot to it. Charlie Brown is depressed and trying to figure out why he's in this mood. He's going to different people for help. Most people aren't really that helpful, as usual. But by the end, Linus gives him a little pep talk. He realizes the true meaning of Christmas. He decides he's not going to let all the commercialism get him down. And it's a happy ending for everyone. It's a really simple story, really sweet. I liked that all the characters are voiced by kids, because you don't always get that. And these kids were really good in their roles. It just made it feel a lot more authentic as something that, like, maybe kids actually would be talking about. I mean, some of them, Lucy and Linus, probably would not say the things that they say. Lucy is far more like a cynical adult, and Linus is sort of like a little too wise beyond his years. But for the most part, they all seemed like real kids, and a lot of that was helped a lot by the fact that real kids were voicing them. Anyway, this is a really sweet animated special. And if you've never seen it, I think I would highly recommend it. It seems like something that would be a good one to make sort of a Christmas tradition. It's just a nice, quiet, sweet thing to sit down with your kids and watch on Christmas Eve or something. It's really great. I highly recommend it.
Linus is right. I won't let all this commercialism ruin my Christmas. I'll take this little tree home and decorate it, and I'll show them it really will work in our play. I've killed it. Oh, everything I touch gets ruined.
Okay, well, that was the last episode of Christmas in July. I want to thank everybody who was a guest on my channel this month. Sarah, Amber, and Rachel. I really enjoyed all of what we did together. I really like doing these episodes with guests. I think it makes it a lot more fun when it's a conversation. I don't mind doing things on my own, but I feel like the episodes are better when we're, like, discussing these things and talking about the different things about them. And especially for something like the Hallmark series, where it's not exactly my cup of tea, but I really had fun talking about it with Amber and Rachel. I think in the future I'm going to try and do more with more people. I really enjoy making these reviews a conversation. In the next month or two, I'm going to be starting some new series, and I think I'm going to try and do more with guests. My first priority is going to be a new show about animation. I'm mainly going to be sticking to older things and maybe indie films. Anyway, you can look forward to next month. I'm going to be doing a whole lot of new things, and I'm really excited about them. If you have any animation requests, let me know. I'll see you next month. Bye.